Hey guys, Mr. Crayfish, and welcome back to my Pocket Edition tutorials. In this tutorial today, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to build a combination locked door. So how this works is very simple. All we're going to do is enter our combination in here. So this one has to be up, and these two have to be down. These two have to be up, and this last one has to be down. And then you'll notice that the door is now open. So this is somewhere where you could probably potentially store secret items, such as your diamonds. And then once you've finished, just reset the combination lock by flicking all the levers up, and you should be safe to go. So I'm going to teach you how to build this now. So the materials you're going to need for this contraption is 10 redstone dust, 10 redstone torches, 6 levers, 1 iron door, and 64 blocks of your choice. Now the first thing I want to do is decide where you want to put your door, so I'm simply going to put mine here. Then what we're going to do is to the right and left of the door is we're going to dig out a block, so one here, then one here. Diagonally right back, we're going to dig out a block here and then one more to the right. Do that the same to the other side, so diagonally left and then just one more. We're going to get our redstone torch and we're going to place it on this front face of this block here and also on that side. We're going to place a piece of redstone dust on that first block, and then on the last one, on the back face, we're going to place a redstone torch here and then a redstone torch here. We're going to get our block of choice now, and what you want to do is place it above this torch here, so one there, oopsie, one there, and then one there. We're going to make a line of blocks coming back here, so 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. Build that up one more layer. And then we're going to get our 6 levers and place them on the top 3 blocks. Oops, not up there. There. And then 1, 2, 3. Now we can actually configure whether the levers have to be up or down for the door to actually open. So let's go ahead and do that now. So if you want the lever to be up, all you simply have to do is place a block down and then place a piece of redstone dust on top. So I'm going to make this first lever have to be up. This second one, I'm going to make it have to be down, so all you simply have to do is place a redstone torch and then a piece of redstone dust under it. And then I might make this last one here again have to be down, so you place a redstone torch and then a piece of redstone dust under it. Now we're going to configure the other side as well, so let's simply just make these first two have to be up for it to open, and then this last one has to be down. And then place a piece of redstone dust under that torch. Now the remaining two redstone, what we want to do is place them on top of this block that the redstone torch is on, and then also on this one, on this side too. Now you might be thinking why I've actually got some redstone torches left, and that is because this is more of a maximum. If you were to make all these levers have to be down for the door to open, then you would actually use all the 10 redstone torches. As you can see, there's could be potential for one torch here and then two torches over this side, but because we're not using them, that's why we've got torches left. Now I actually made a mistake. What we actually need to do is break this door down, so just break that down, and you're going to place it in an open position. So instead of placing it like we did initially, just in the closed position, we're going to place it sideways like this. And then you want to enter your combination in real quickly, so these two have to be down, and then this kind of last one here has to be down. And then what you want to do, once you've done that, flick that back up, and then you should notice that your door has now updated and will only open when you enter the correct combination, as so. Now I'm going to teach you guys how this actually works, and it is very simple. So let's start with the levers here. Now the idea is basically to get this redstone line here turned off. So you can imagine, if we were to actually power this lever here, that's going to power this redstone behind it, meaning that it's turned on. So this lever has to be up. Now, these redstone torches will be on if these levers are actually up. So now the redstone's on, and that means the door would be closed. But if we flick the lever here, it's going to turn that redstone torch off, which then allows this redstone wire to come off. Now, because this is off, it turns on this redstone torch, which then turns off that redstone torch that we placed under this block here. And basically the same thing happens on this side as well. These ones have to be up and this last one has to be down, which then doesn't power this redstone, and then that this last one turns off this redstone torch, which means the redstone wire is off, allowing this torch to come on, which then turns off this redstone torch under this block here. And then once both these torches under these blocks are turned off, the door will open. But anyway, that's going to end off this redstone tutorial today. If you enjoyed, make sure you hit that like button, shows your support for this new series of mine. If you have any ideas for redstone tutorials, let me know in the comments. And also subscribe, because if you don't, you won't be notified of new tutorials that I do. But anyway, I will see you guys later. Bye bye.